We had the pre-party going because there's so much rain going on. We got our guest, Robert Christopher Ryan.
Bop, bop, bop.
Bop, 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 bop.
What's going on? What's going on, people? How y'all doing?
Hi, TP.
Hey.
Hi, K-Way.
Wes. Wes is in the building.
Wes. Happy New Year.
For real.
I feel like it's the countdown. Hey, LeBron. Hi, cousin. So he's gonna keep it like peace. He's so quiet. He doesn't speak much.
Do we let the engineer chill, man? Let that man do him, please.
I just want, you know, sometimes.
Oh, you about to give him the mic?
He got that God mic too.
Bust that hot nine real quick.
He got the God mic.
Oh, see, sometimes I say he raps as well.
Flow.
What's up, everybody? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too. As a matter of fact, let me get these cans on.
That's going to help my situation out.
Is it? Is it? Okay.
I'm on your neck. You know,
here we go.
You ain't going to be able to hear
it. Well, now I got you. I got
neck.
The one
hold
in. I'm good.
I like it.
What's it that
let me get the little,
neck?
I'm about to just, I can stretch forward here, LaRon. Okay. This is good, Pierce. All right.
You're straight, brother.
All right. Thank you. Here we go. Now I'm ready. I got my lean back position and whatnot. I'm chilling.
Lean back.
New York is in the building. Brooklyn's in the house.
Oh my God, I got a little excited. Speaking of New York, you know, that was very East Coast.
How was that? I missed that.
You know what? I'm going to just say this.
Please.
I enjoyed seeing Method Man. I enjoyed seeing everybody on it. I don't know. I think it was good. You know what? I got lost a little bit in the story. But I think it was good. Did you watch the breaks?
I sure didn't.
Okay.
He's a busy man.
I was probably editing video or something like that. I gotta be sure I make time on my schedule to watch Hit the Floor when it comes back.
Right, exactly. But no, I mean, it's another fellow VH1, something. I mean, it got a lot of publicity and it was a lot going on in the movie, but I think it was good. I mean, it's showed the hip hop. It reminded me of some really, like, say the era of, it reminded me of like the Run DMC.
Okay.
Russell Simmons.
All
like,
right.
Getting that started, but it was more about a management and talent and how they wanted
to
get it. It was that. It was like, you know, it was kind of like mixing of the eras.
And it was good?
It was good.
You hesitated.
You know what? I think I'm falling asleep. I'm going to be
okay.
Honest.
All right. You know what? We're just going to give that another try and another day.
I think that we need to, like, go to Hot Topics.
Well, I mean, let's not give our review of the breaks while
really
we was half sleep.
Yeah, we was half sleep. Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, I'm a fan of Method Man, and it was a lot of great acting.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I think that the
M-E-T-H-O-D,
acting was
good. M-E-T-H-O-D, man. M-E-T-H-O-D, man. See, West Coast people listen to East Coast.
Did you hear about when Wu-Tang sold their album for $1 million to one person? And
two.
Now, $2 million to one person.
And
now
what happened?
He's the guy who's in jail or something.
Exactly.
So now.
For an HIV pill.
For what?
Oh yeah, no, that was that dude. It's this crazy pharmacist dude.
Yeah.
Who like rack? That's a terrible story. He raised the prices of a prominent medication for HIV just so he can make a ridiculous amount of money. It used to cost like maybe $2 or something a pill, and he raised it to like $75 a pill, knowing full well that means a lot of people aren't gonna be able to afford it. Blah blah blah. But he just doesn't care. So.
And I think that was really just. I don't know a lot about what the Obamacare or what all of those things are, but I mean, yeah. I think that that was a big issue about what pharmaceutical companies do, is that they get a patent on a product and no one else can make it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, until your patent runs out.
Until your patent runs out, you are the only one.
Then they just bootleg that shit in India.
Or Mexico, somewhere.
Speaking of Mexico, did y'all, you know, what? Say stuff and it comes to mind since, you know, we've been on a 2-week hiatus.
We have.
A new mayor was elected in Mexico. It was a female.
Oh, and they killed her.
And then she got shot the very next day.
Yeah.
Mexico is dangerous. Like,
nah, I was going to go Cancun coming out. I don't know. Mm-mm,
no, I'm good. But they don't kidnap black people.
But I got let me tell you.
Colorado.
Bro, I'm going to tell you right now, you ain't worth a dime in Mexico. You owe a couple shades too brown for you to be worth anything in Mexico.
Well, I was told I'm last show, I was told I'm not light skinned.
You are not light skinned.
I was told I'm not light skinned.
Nah, that ship sailed a long time ago. No pun intended.
I missed that show. But both of y'all two, y'all got that good island like tan.
I mean, you know, hey, I'm brown.
I've like, never been to the island.
I just came back from Bermuda, but yeah, no, I mean, look, I traced my DNA through Ancestry.com, and 86% of it comes from Africa, so we just got dropped off earlier than everybody else in America. That's all it is. It's the same thing. That's straight up and down. If you think, you know what I mean, we got dropped off somewhere else, held on to a culture, which is probably the biggest difference between African descendants that grew up in the islands or that come from the islands and opposed to those in America, is that Americans were so robbed of their culture when they came here, whereas the, you know, African descendants that were in the other islands, they have that island culture that is a hodgepodge of whatever it is. And then here in America, we just, you know, keep getting shitted on by. I'm part of it. You know what I mean? I'm part of it. I was born here, but I have that culture from somewhere else. I'm first generation American born. But I mean, make no mistake, being black in America is a whole different sack of potatoes. Man, like for real, for real.
How heavy is that sack of potatoes?
Ain't from Idaho.
Nope. Sure ain't.
Definitely ain't from Idaho.
I think something you said, you're unapologetically Caribbean.
Yes, but yes.
You were born and raised in New York, right?
Yeah, born and raised Flatbush, Brooklyn.
What do you mean by that?
I mean that I'm Caribbean, you know. First of all, newsflash, there's a bunch of different types of black people, which is probably kind of what Blackish is about. Not kind of, right. That's what it's about. Right. And it's about time we embrace that. We embrace our differences. We embrace the diaspora that is, at the African descendants. Mm-hmm. That is many of our Spanish-speaking descendants. Mm-hmm. And when I say I'm unapologetically Caribbean, it's like, you're not going to get me to not enjoy my music. You're not going to get me to not listen to soca. You're not going to get me to not go to carnival because I'm supposed to somehow conform to what the idea of being black is, what the idea of being a celebrity is, what the idea of being a black celebrity is, which is again a whole different sack of potatoes. I refuse to conform to any of those things in many people's opinions, to my detriment. But the thing is, if you don't want those things that you won't get by being yourself, then you're not missing out on anything. You know what I mean?
You gotta be you.
Yeah.
You gotta be
if
you.
You don't want that, it doesn't really matter. It's like, let's say you got a homegirl who's one of these trollops that chases after athletes, right? Like, that's her main thing.
That's her thing.
I'm not talking about somebody who happens to date an athlete and happens to look a certain way. I'm talking about somebody like that's what they do. Every year we go on All-Star Weekend, girl.
Right, right.
This what we doing, right? Okay. So if you got one of those homegirls, that's just what she does.
Right.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. That I'm not gonna tell her to not be that kind of person. I'm not, she has no right to tell you, and at the same time, you have no right to tell her how to be.
Yeah.
And in saying that, if you don't want what it is that she gets as a result of being that NBA trollop, then you're not missing out on anything.
Right.
She could be like, oh, girl, you don't got that, but I just got these shoes. I just got this bag. I just went to
but
this place. I just went to.
Your rent, I pay.
Or whatever it is. Let's say homeboy is paying her rent and her tags are right. Even if you don't want that, then you ain't missing nothing.
Nothing.
You know what I mean? It's like, and the same thing goes for dudes. If you don't want to be hoeing, then you ain't missing nothing by not hoeing. You know what I mean? It's like,
don't save her. My back hurt.
All right.
Team Soca.
Team Soca. Hollywood Massive.
Bop. Hold on. You're going to make me just.
Hey.
hold on, wait. I think I'm prepared for this situation. I'm always prepared.
What are we doing?
I'm always prepared for this situation.
Turn that Tobago.
Well, first of all, you got to have both. You know what I mean?
Hey, shouts out. I had a friend who just hit me up from Dallas, Texas. She said, shout out to Soca.
Oh, yes.
And
Soca
Carnival.
To the world. Soca, Carnival to the world.
How do you feel that's what about we do. Carnival coming to Los Angeles?
Come on, baby. I'm one of the people that's helping bring Carnival to Los Angeles.
I know you are.
I love it.
You love it?
Absolutely. I mean, I started this company, Hollywood Massive. It's a production company.
Okay.
And we produce Mass. Mm-hmm. Mass is short for Masquerade. That's what Carnival is. We call it Mass.
Okay.
So
right.
If anybody ever hears or somebody saying, you going to play Mass this year, it means, are you going to get dressed up and be in Carnival? That's
I'm
what it means.
Be in one of those outfits like
listen,
Rihanna,
we got diamonds. You. We got you. Rihanna and me from the same place. That's Barbados.
This
is what we do.
Diamonds and the feathers.
Yo, you got to check
it
out.
Like,
oh, my God. Hollywood, at Hollywood Massive on Instagram. You're going to see everything you could possibly need.
And Hollywood Massive.
YouTube.com/HollywoodMassive. You can see everything. At the end of the day, you're going to be in Hollywood Carnival. It's during the 5th annual Los Angeles Culture Festival. This year is June 25th.
Okay.
Right down Hollywood Boulevard.
That's the same time the
BET Awards is the next day. Right, right.
It's going to be a big deal.
Come on. Carnival is a big, big business. Hey, mind your business.
Oh, I love that. You know, we have a great Caribbean restaurant in the front. They actually happen to be closed today.
Oh,
shout out to Brownstone Bistro.
All right, let
what
me find out.
What was your favorite Caribbean dish?
Oh, hands down, curry chicken roti. You can't even gotta say no more than that. I was raised Trinidadian. This is what we do. Trinis eat, you know, eat curry and roti. That's what we do.
What is roti?
Roti is an Indian flatbread. You would probably call it a West Indian burrito, right? So it's an Indian flatbread it's wrapped. It's got potato and chana. And a meat or vegetables or shrimp or whatever it is that's curried with turmeric and so on and so forth. And your curry has to come from Trinidad and India. Oh, yeah, yeah. No, I got my spices in my cabinet, girl.
Oh my goodness.
Come on. Listen, I'm a Caribbean man. I don't always have, a Caribbean woman in my life or my mother or whatever. I got to make sure I can cook my food. God bless, you know, the lady who tries to cook Caribbean food.
For you.
You know.
Okay, because she can't make
it. It'd be delicious, though.
That's all that matters.
That's all I'm saying. Okay.
So,
yeah.
Scrumptious.
Speaking, we spoke about women and all these women. They're so excited that you were on today.
Hey, what's up, ladies?
Looking at you But do you have a special person? Because I was like on the rumor mill, and I'm not usually into all this, like,
rumor
you know, like
mill.
Rumors.
Uh-oh.
But somebody told me
I'm
they
a,
was
I'm
like,
I'm putting a hoodie on that
him
one.
And
right.
Ryan,
I'm a
hot item. And I was
20
like, oh my God, I don't know. I said, but you know, usually I don't get into the business, but I would like to know.
Yeah.
Are you dating?
So you see, this right here is not tea.
To the shade room on that.
This
isn't
tea. I don't participate in such things. My life is very complete and very happy.
Mm-hmm.
And this is bourbon is delicious.
He just enjoying life.
That's what I'm talking about. Okay.
So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and Carnival is a big business. Mind your business.
Yeah,
Google that song and just listen to it over and over again.
That part right there. So you have an impressive acting resume. I mean, you've been on TV. You've been on film.
Yeah.
And you've been on the Broadway stage.
I sure have.
So, I mean,
I gotta give it up for that man.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yes. You the man.
Huzzah.
Hands down. I mean, like, we were just, you know, like, sometimes it's like, oh my God, I don't know what to say. Like, Broadway is live. You can't mess up. TV
nah.
is kind of like, they're like, okay, redo that. Which do you enjoy? Is there pressure? Like, can you explain the differences between the three? Because you've been involved in all of them.
Well, there's pressure in all of them. At the end of the day, you're telling a story everywhere you are.
Right.
So there's that. I love telling stories. I don't really care what the medium is. If somebody was to give me a make me choose or force me to choose, and then you say you could only do one thing forever. Well, if I was concerned about money, then I would of course want to do television
or film because
you're going to get incredible amount of money. But I really love people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, I like bringing people together, and during the theater performance, you know, a lot of times it'll be 1,200 people in one building or in one room. 1,200 of us, and we're all breathing the same air and feeling that same tension, that same elation, that same, you know, the sadness, whatever it is, all the different the emotional ride that you go on through a play, mm-hmm. whether it's a comedy or a musical, whatever it is, we all go through that together. And then when I come out on the stage door, even if I'm appreciating the theater or I'm one of the performers, that exchange afterward is immediate. Mm-hmm. So you saw me in that show. I know what you just saw. When you're saying thank you and how much it means to you or whatever it is, then I'm like, oh, okay, I know what that was. Mm-hmm. When somebody's like, yo, I love Hit the Floor, I'm like, yeah, me too. That was dope. I remember doing that. I had a great time. Those are my peoples. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I shot that. We're in January 2016. I shot Hit the Floor in January 2015.
Really?
You know what I mean?
It was
delayed a little bit this year.
Okay.
But January, February, March, April of last year is when I was shooting Hit the Floor. So
Wow. It's
a little bit different. There's a little bit of a disconnect. I've got to remember what season 3 of Hit the Floor was about.
You're
like, yo, I just saw that. You were fantastic. I'm like, that's yay. Thank you. I mean, thank you for watching it. We didn't share that same moment in time.
Right.
You know what I mean? There's a human connection that I get from you as an audience member in theater that I don't have in film and television. However, in film and television, you get the opportunity to reach so many more people mm-hmm. in one fell swoop, mm-hmm. and you get a bigger platform. So if you wanted to, say, affect the world, mm-hmm. then film and television is going to be a better medium for you, because one, you get to still tell stories, but a lot more people are going to know who you are, therefore you'll have more people's attention, and what you do with that attention is obviously up to you.
I feel it's like great that there's so many platforms. I mean, I like the, even the fact that this is an online platform and we're in here, and it's like, we don't know, but I mean, we could look and it'll be like, oh, it's over 60,000 people watching us, and it's like,
yeah.
You don't even know who you're talking to. Sometimes I forget, and then look and be like, oh my God, that many people tuned in.
Yeah, so I try not to forget. I try not to forget.
You know, it's like, okay, sit the cup down because you were doing too much. Like, you know what I mean? We forget. But it's just, when you're on camera, like, how did you know when you started, like, because you went to school, right? Like,
yeah.
Like, you got a master's in...
Yeah, I've got a bachelor of theaters.
I gotta say this real quick, because some of our ladies...
What happened?
Don't give us men a lot of credit, because... You know, I ain't saying none of y'all, because I know y'all educated and smart and all that.
Right.
It's valedictorian.
I know. How you know that?
I know a lot about you.
Oh, congratulations.
He's so nosy, though. He'd be like, who the picture of that? Who's this? I'd be like, damn.
I'm the most interesting.
You nosy, too, though.
I'm the most interesting.
You nosy. But go ahead. I don't want to throw you off.
No, what I'm going to say is, for a man who is talented as my brother is...
He is. Well, I can't say brother. Well spoken. I just like looking at him, my mouth goes open.
You know what? Pineapples. You know, I'm lesbian, but still, the point I'm trying to make is, as talented, and I'll say, you know, he got big shoulders. I can't say handsome.
I have big shoulders.
But gifted as this guy, as God made this brother,
right.
He was blessed with a brain.
He was. Oh, man. Yes.
Thanks.
I have to give
Thanks,
him
Mom.
A major props for doing what he did. So
I appreciate that. Thank you.
But go ahead, Sharice. I'll be quiet now.
Well, you know, I got ADHD. It's like, once the 5 minutes go by, you pass my 30-second time span.
But I ain't nosy, though.
You are nosy.
But, you know, you were right. I have a Bachelor of Arts in Theater. I have a Master of Fine Arts in acting.
Yeah, so doing that, that's what I wanted to say. Thank you for bringing, you know what?
No problem.
Robert Christopher Riley. Hey. What the shit.
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? So what I was saying by that is, you've experienced every aspect of, and there's so many digital platforms now.
Yeah.
So there's so many ways to get your art out to the masses.
Mm-hmm.
And you have Hollywood masses. Speaking of masses, Hollywood masses. Bringing the carnival.
Yeah.
Hey, Team Soka.
Shout out to Hoi Pong Customs, Hoi Pong Printing for my hat.
Okay. Yeah. Well, shout out to them. What's up? But I mean, like, okay, but you actually went to school for your craft.
Yeah.
So how did you know that you were going to, like, come and say, I'm going to be an actor?
This also, I did a promo for VH1 today, and they were like, you know, what is something that people don't know about you? And I was like, well, most people don't know that I'm Caribbean. That just watch Hit the Floor. If you follow me on Instagram and you don't know I'm Caribbean, frankly, you're an idiot. But and you probably don't care about me and shouldn't be following me or whatever, so it doesn't matter. But, what a lot of people don't know is that I didn't go to school to be an actor. I went to school to be an accountant and a football player.
Oh, word.
Yeah, yeah. So I went to Lehigh. I had no interest in being an actor, and Lehigh wasn't this amazing school for theater or anything like that. It happens to have the oldest drama society in the country, which I'm a part of.
Okay.
Which is also something that people probably would never think, but So I went to school to be an accountant, and Lehigh is a predominantly white school. And when I say predominantly, I mean when I was there, it was 93% white. 93%. So they were doing a production of A Raisin in the Sun my freshman year, second semester freshman year. So my I was in an intro to acting class the second semester of that year, and my professor, and who was an adjunct professor and alum at the time, Cassie Johnson, black woman from Queens. I'm just saying, representing Queens. She was raised out in Brooklyn, but so Cassie was going to be in A Raisin in the Sun. They asked me to audition. They needed more black actors. I said no a bunch of times because it wasn't what I did. I was a football player. I was an accountant. I was from Brooklyn. I didn't do any of that whack shit as far as I was concerned. And then I felt a sense of responsibility.
So hard sometimes
because it is a really tough place to grow up. I'll be honest with you. That's why.
Carl Kanai was on our show. He's from Brooklyn. And it's like, it's like everybody from Brooklyn.
Nah, here's
you're
the
not
thing.
From Brooklyn, you like, be in the club, you be like, Brooklyn?
Nah, here's the thing. Look, all right, Brooklyn. I'm not going to say that Brooklyn is the toughest place to grow up, because I've been in some very, very, very shitty neighborhoods in America. I've been to Baltimore. I've been to Cincinnati. I've been to a lot of really, really rough places. Mm-hmm. But where I grew up in Brooklyn, and a lot of people that grew up in Brooklyn grow up with very, very little. And there's so many of us that grow up with very little. Right. And there's so many of us that grow up in these tough conditions. And there are so many people in such a small area that it amplifies everything. Right. So, I mean, I grew up in Brooklyn in the 80s during the crack epidemic. So I grew up not being able to go to the basketball court because people were getting shot and stabbed and kicking crack vials off of a playground and knowing what red tops were and seeing people dead in the basement lobby. Red tops was a small vial of crack cocaine on the top of his red. You know what I'm saying? So I grew up in all of that. So here I am. I'm this dude that went to Lehigh University that has a Bachelor of Arts in Theater, that we had a Master of Fine Arts in Acting. But I grew up in Flatbush, Brooklyn during the crack epidemic in the 80s. Brooklyn to me is a place that it wasn't very likely for me to get out of. I know a lot of people that I went to school with, public school, Catholic school, that never made it out. Wow. That just didn't make it out. They never left Brooklyn.
I was just about to say, what was the childhood like? Was it you have brothers, sisters, your mother?
I got one older brother. Father wasn't there. Mom had to leave my father when I was about 2 years old. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You did your research. Go ahead, girl. I see that. So I was raised by just my mother and my maternal grandmother. She came over from Trinidad when I was about 2 years old. She was born in 1910, so I was raised like really old school Caribbean in my house. And then being in Flatbush, Brooklyn, I was raised, in a Caribbean.
Like to say it.
Me too. It's actually a Dutch like word, but whatever.
Dutch? Brooklyn is Dutch?
Yeah, yeah. It's like it's initially spelled Breukelen or something like that.
See, that's what the masters like do, girls. don't let the good looks fool you. Because he really knows what he's talking about.
Hey,
he knows the origin. You know how I say this is the Latin? It comes from the Latin origin.
But I will also protect you in the streets. So you know what I'm saying? We gotta keep a gangster.
Yeah. I like to say Inglewood.
Mm-hmm. Inglewood. I'm from Inglewood.
I like to say Inglewood too. That's because I really liked Tupac when I was.
I like the fact that Dr. Dre, when he did
Inglewood,
the
always up to no good. Even Hollywood trying to get a piece of it. Pasadena, where you at?
That line right there. That line should get so much trouble in college.
Come on, man.
From Inglewood, yes. Wow.
Yes, I am indeed. Inglewood. That's why Brooklyn is the way it is. That's why people are so that way about Brooklyn. And it's been that way for decades and decades and decades. Even like old white people that were in Brooklyn back in the day, Brooklyn was always the bastard son of Manhattan, of New York. So we come from this great place where we're treated like second class citizens.
Right.
If you're from Brooklyn and you're going to Manhattan, you say, I'm going to the city.
Right.
All five boroughs are part of New York City.
Right.
But Manhattan is the city. You know what I mean?
Right.
Not as people in Williamsburg bleeding out and so on and so forth. So the people are getting a different bit of a vibe of Brooklyn.
Right.
Barclays is there. You see Beyonce and Jay. and Jay-Z used to sell drugs, not too far from the Barclays Center, so that's why he's comfortable there. Don't trip, you know what I mean? Like, it's not, he would have been comfortable there no matter what. He's always been comfortable there. It's not like, you know. So anyway,
I'm kind of sad to say this.
Mm-hmm. Hey,
of the many, many places I've been to in life, I've never been in New York.
Really? Oh man, we got room for you.
And you heard me say my man Tony Rock name many times before here. Good friend, he always said, whenever you ready to come to New York, let me know, son.
Tony Rock's the man. Like that.
Every time I wanted to go to New York, I'm picky about where I want to go, because I want to go when football and basketball season both end, because I want to catch the New York Giants game, a Brooklyn Nets game, and the New York Knicks game.
You know what? I went to an All-Star game in New York, and then I also went when I had to. I felt like I needed to go there for New Year's, but I was so freaking cold.
Yeah,
this was the New Year's when it was like a negative 3 or
it's
12.
Nasty cold. Any
I was
New
like
Year's,
this. We found our way to. I want to. I can't think of the name when I'm pressured. I can't think. But it was some kind of barbecue.
You're pressured right now.
No, I'm not pressured. I can't think of the name of it. It was like it's a barbecue joint.
Okay.
I had to pee.
Was it good?
No.
You was in Manhattan, like in Times Square, like Blue Smoke, something like that. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Go ahead.
BBQs?
Yeah, BBQs. Yeah.
Is that the name of it?
Hell yeah.
BBQs.
Yeah, you can eat it, BBQs. Okay. BBQs is delicious as long as you don't mind diabetes.
What?
It's terrible for you.
I mean, you know, I just felt the need to. But I was
there goes my BBQ sponsorship.
No.
I was just so cold. My toes were frozen. So, I mean, you know, it's like being from LA. I just felt like I had to see the ball drop.
Yeah. You can watch that on TV. From New York, never seen it live. Didn't miss nothing. Why would I see it live? It's so cold. It's like December 31st. You're like, oh, I'm in New York. I'm going to go to this ball. If you're in New York, you were in New York on the 24th of December, the 25th of December. All them cold days leading up to the 31st. You ain't trying to stand outside in the middle of the night to watch the ball drop in the same Times Square that you try to avoid because of traffic. Because you live in... No, that ain't happening.
Right. I know what you mean. Like, I mean, I did it one time and... I did it. I can say that I did it.
Yes, you did.
I've done it.
Everyone should do it once, or at least attempt. Think about it.
I have to.
Do people know that you're here? Because I feel like I'm like looking over, like whoever's watching this show is seeing me look over here, and they probably think I'm talking to no one.
TP always talks about.
But there's actually a very attractive woman over here who is one of the producers of this show.
Yeah, the ball don't drop. Don't make the drink drop.
What is in there?
She told us for 2016, gold is her color, so she's golden.
I said for the month of January that gold is my color. So basically, it's not 2016 all the way back.
I'm using this opportunity to get some ginger ale.
Let's do that.
If you do not know who this is TP.
Yes.
We don't say her real name, but this is TP. TP is fabulous.
She does everything.
She is mostly behind the scenes. She take care of our social media. She take care of scheduling our guests, booking our guests, and 50,000 other things. We love TP.
This is my family, and I love them to death, and I so appreciate everybody here, you know, the energy that I get. It's amazing.
This is our first week back, and it's our first show of the show.
And
we're so excited.
Put me on camera.
She hates to be on camera, but here's the thing.
I'm like, can you just please?
But she was so dressed appropriately for today.
I know.
Hey, Rob.
Shout out to Mr. Pierce. Timing is impeccable. The man's timing is impeccable. That's why he's a producer.
TP, but on some real shit. Listen, we did some stuff during the holiday season. And it's always good, you know. During the holiday season, it's like the season of giving. You want to give back, and everybody talk about it. But sometimes you got to just be about what you're talking about.
Yes.
And something, you know, if you be about it, you don't even really have to talk about it, because it's like, you know, it just does what it does.
For sure.
We made it do what it do. We did something that was really unique with a friend that you introduced me to that you've been worked with in previous years, and I want to get to a video. I want to keep it going with what you're talking about.
Oh, no doubt. Oh, I'm here. I'm good. Y'all got me some drink. I'm chilling.
Yeah. I want you to.
Yes, sir.
Stay comfortable.
If anybody knows anything about Caribbean people, you give me a drink and a chair, and we're gonna be all right.
We're just gonna talk this one out.
We're gonna talk this one out.
Right. But this holiday season, you know, we wanted to make sure that Beauty and the Beat did something that we felt that we could give back, whether it be donating food, whether it be donating toys. We did participate in a few. Is that hair on my hat? Anybody tell me?
You know what? I mean,
nah, that's what I'll be talking about. Y'all, you know, we good. So anyway, but I want to get into. Something that we did with the rescue mission that was really important. Can you want to talk a little bit, TP?
You know what? I can just say that, you know, I enjoyed my experience with my new family here, Beauty and the Beat. You know, we had an amazing. I'm gonna need you to bring that up a little bit.
I mean, Lord knows, right. I would be forgiven for my sins later for that
one. I'm talking and everything's like right here.
I'm just all about that little baby curl right
the
by your
hair,
ear.
The baby hair.
Nah, there's just one tiny little curl. Y'all can't see it because I don't know if we're in HD right now, but she got one really small curl, and it is everything.
We did it.
Just want to pull it.
I just want
to
pull it.
It wasn't about publicity. It wasn't about giving back.
And you know, we were there, you know, supporting and making sure that, you know, that it was a 50 man volunteer. It was a 50 man dinner that we put on.
Oh man, that's awesome.
Yeah, and
it's just giving back to men that have addiction, that have lost their way kind of, and that are finding their way back into society.
Absolutely.
Getting back, whether they're lost from their family, whether they're lost from their children, whether they're lost from a disconnect from society and people have forgotten about them.
Absolutely.
And letting them know that no one else has forgotten about them. And to give back and see people to unite themselves and share their stories and come together and know that they are supported and that they can be supported and come and have a meal,
right,
that someone home prepared for them
and get it back.
So I'm gonna get into a little video of Beauty and the Beat. We were there, and then I'm gonna fix my hat, and then we're gonna go to that.
My hair popping.
In fact, right. Why don't you do it?
Why?
You need a minute to, like, you knew that you fucked
get
up.
Get situated.
See how the engineer
let that man get situated.
Let's go to the video.
Like, can we go to the video or no?
In due time, we're getting there.
Give me a couple seconds. I'm almost on.
We need a couple of pretty faces.
Can't get
the lips.
But anyway,
the duck lips.
Can we get that? So while we're preparing this video about what we did with the rescue mission, TP, it was a really big deal. I felt good about it.
I applaud you guys for doing that. That's awesome. I mean, giving back is one of those things that you don't need a specific platform to do.
And you don't need to talk about it. You just got to do it. Because if you're about it, then people will know. Because I know, even with you, we were talking about the Martin Luther King Parade. You participated this year, the Taste of the Caribbean. And is it called Mo City or something that you participate with in giving back? What is that
about? I'm a mentor, and I mentor and teach kids. I used to be with a group called Mokiti. I used to be with them. That group doesn't exist anymore. So now I do the group that I'm affiliated with now is actually the Screen Actors Guild. They have a program called Book Pals.
Oh, okay.
So I go to schools and read stories to kids out loud, like we did back in the day. I literally go have story time with children. So I'm that guy too.
So what do you read? What kind of stories?
And I'm also the person that will get you drunk as shit during carnival and read to your children the next day. All right, and so you know what I mean? And tell you the Dutch origin of Brooklyn and protect you in the street. Come on now.
Brooklyn.
Yes, exactly.
I love that. I want to go to Brooklyn with you because you're from there. Like,
yeah.
There's nothing like touring New York
with somebody that is
from there.
Nothing wrong with that.
Like, when you go, it's like, you know, I mean, it's like, I just want to go.
My family's from New York.
So and Virginia?
What part?
Queens.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Like, can't you hear it in her voice? Like, she's been here forever. But
I have. But my mother moved from New York to Virginia and had me. So that's why I'm from Virginia.
Somebody back from Virginia.
Right.
You know, I call my lady, you know, the Lady V, the Queen V is... Never mind.
Right.
What happened now?
That's an off-screen conversation.
I am alone in this room right now. I'm feeling real vulnerable, folks. I don't know if y'all is anybody out there still watching. Help! Help! Help!
So she went from Queens to Virginia. Right.
Baby, I didn't do it.
Honestly, what he was saying, like, you know, I get it. Like, yeah, that whole thing, that New York, that whole. But you're out here now.
I am. Yeah.
So
no.
Basically, you know what? I love New York, but it's such a rude place.
Like, well, I'm not one. You know what it is? I'll tell you what. New York is full of so many different people, right, that a lot of times the people that you run into in New York aren't rude. Right. They're on their way somewhere.
Yes.
And they're in a rush.
Right.
They're already late.
Right.
They don't have time for your question.
Right.
Okay? And that's really what it's not that they don't want to answer your question. It's not that they don't like you.
Like that. It's just more of a realness.
Yeah, it's like, look, as a matter of fact, I don't even have time to tell you that I'm not going to answer you. I'm just going to keep walking because I am late.
Hold on. I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I represent the West. Which is the best. From where I'm from, because we don't smoke no stress. But anyway, I get mad props to the East Coast. Right, that's all right. I
do love that. The East Coast is, the difference between the East Coast and the West Coast is the East Coast moves fast, but they think a little slower. But the West Coast, no, East Coast, they move
fast and talk slower.
Yeah, and then what's the West Coast?
We talk a lot slower.
I'm gonna be 100% honest.
Who that?
From my point of view,
people in LA will stab you in the back.
Stab you in the chest, right in the chest.
That's what the state is.
Stab you like this,
right in your chest.
What's going on.
Right,
yeah,
and, right.
And that's
something I will always say about East Coast people. They are so 100% genuine,
right? Yeah.
And I will always respect that.
Well, I will say that.
Think I'm from the East. I'm like, no.
I'll give you this about LA, because I oftentimes have to try and explain this. I've been here for 4 years now. Jesus Christ, it's 4 years.
So you live in New York, pretty much, girl.
I grew up in born and raised Flappers, Brooklyn. Until I went to college, I was at Lehigh for 5 years, and I was at Ohio for 3 years.
Okay.
Then I was on the road and was in New York for a little bit, and then moved out here. But most of the people that are in LA that make up LA, the LA that people don't like, aren't from here.
True.
They're not actually from here. They're from somewhere else. You know what I mean? They're transplants. They're the people that are here for Hollywood, for the show business.
Thank you.
And you've got to understand that the show business. I'm here for checks.
You want them.
I am here for the checks. You, listen, let me tell you something. I'm from New York. I'm from Brooklyn. I'm Caribbean. I live in Los Angeles. I have created a company. I so miss where I'm from that I created a company that one of the sole purposes, not one of the sole, the sole purpose of this company is to increase cultural awareness in Los Angeles and places like it, which is a lot of America.
Cultural awareness about the what?
About the Caribbean, and then about cultures like it, because like most people would say, if they heard me talking in my native dialects, pick one, Trinidad or Bajan, they would tell me that, you sound Jamaican, and that's ridiculous, because I don't, and they don't sound anything alike each other, but that's without any proper cultural awareness or education. You would just go, everyone's, you know, you guys are all Jamaican. The same thing they do with everyone that's from South or Central America here. You're all Mexican. Okay. No, we're not. They're not. You know what I mean? I talk to people.
Right. That's the diaspora you were talking about.
That's the diaspora, yes.
Okay,
we all come from, and many of the slaves at the end of the day come from West Africa, right? Mm-hmm. Like, look it up. Mm-hmm. So we were all from that place. The diaspora was the spice trade that took us and dropped us off in all these different places up along the east coast of America and through all the islands of the Caribbean. That's why the Dominican Republic and Haiti are the same island of Hispaniola. It's just some mountains, and the Spanish people took one side and the French people took another side. But you got some descendants there that are arguing over some shit that two different sets of European people left a long time ago. You know what I mean? Like, it's so that's how I say all that to say, that's how much I miss where I'm from. Like, I'm from home. Like, I'm from home.
You're about your culture, and you're about
and everybody should be.
They should be.
You know what I mean? You should, like, have something to be about.
I want to go to Brooklyn right now.
Come on.
Wait, what?
I mean, I just, not to live.
You can go to Brooklyn.
Just a visit.
I'll be in the islands.
There you go. There you go. We can stop in Brooklyn and fly out of JFK.
I've never been to Barbados.
Oh, man. Barbados is beautiful.
There you go.
I mean, Trinidad is amazing, but Barbados is.
Yeah. Like, I would love to go to Barbados. What are you guys
saying? Come on.
How about this? Let's go ahead and show that video from which I did over the holiday season.
Oh, we're back to the
movie. I want to go to. Because
we got a big question for him. After this.
Oh.
Yes, we do. We have to.
Dun, dun, dun.
Let's go ahead and let's go into the what happened, which I did over this holiday season.
Mission. We want to talk about that because I think it was important. I enjoyed it.
And we talked about it, though.
Yeah.
No,
but we gonna roll the video. It's video time. Oh, okay. Rescue mission video.
We still got a little time left, so.
Yeah, let's do
Mr.
that.
Mr. Engineer.
Let's make it happen back to.
Executioner.
Rob Christopher.
So, hi, Latasha.
How are you?
I'm well,
thank you.
Thank you for having us out. This is a wonderful day and experience. Can you tell us a little bit about why you are here and what today is all about?
Well, what today is all about is it's called the 50-minute lesson. I mean, the reason why it's capped off at 50 minutes is because there's different amounts in each class.
Okay.
There are different walks, there are different alcohol, strokes, there's different things like that.
And the class is a 12-step program?
12-step program, okay. Yes, definitely. For drugs, for alcohol, whatever your addiction is.
Okay.
Because your addiction can be shot.
True.
Right.
Don't say
that. But true.
True.
And the reason why I started it is because God put it on my heart to be a blessing to somebody else. When you stand in need of a blessing, it's always good to bless someone else.
I'll never forget, I was driving down the street. I was fresh from my divorce. And I was driving down, it was El Nino also. And this particular day I had a water. I don't do water. So I'm driving down the street, he goes the opposite direction. Again, I said I was facing, you know, after my divorce. Donnie has been like a friend to me more than in certain instances. So he's driving the opposite direction and we know each other and we just want to tell the truth and shame the devil. We met each other in the negative, but God turned it out to be a very positive thing. So driving opposite directions and I'm like, okay, Lord, why am I going down the street? It's El Nino outside. I need to be at home and, you know, talking to God and this and that. Long story short, Donnie goes, I need to come over to your house. What? Immediately I was excited. However, my mindset, I'm thinking like, come over my house for what? He comes over to my house and I let nobody over my house because that's still, you know, I still respect my home. Until I was divorced, I respected my home. Donnie came over to my house and he said, Tasha, I need something for you. Oh Lord, I was like, oh my gosh. My mind, you know, the mind can play tricks on you, make you think something totally opposite of what God has for you.
You're right.
Right immediately, he says to me, this, and he was a lot bigger than this, to be honest with you. And he says to my little 5-foot frame self, Tasha, you start shaking, talking about, I need peace. I'm like, a piece of cake, like, what are you? He's like, no, Tasha, I need peace. Now, mind you, he used to invite me to his church. I would go with him out of my flesh, let's be honest. So I'll be like, okay, if it pleases him, I'm gonna go to church, put my good clothes on. However, what I didn't realize that God was setting me up. Randall can tell you that, you know, we meet across the street, and exterior-wise, people judge, but I can pray you through a storm. And when I tell you, it won't be a dry eye once I get done.
And I made that vow to God. If you bless me, Lord, I bless somebody else. My father was on drugs for 25 plus years. He was an alcoholic for a very long time. And through God's grace, you know, he showed me both aspects of it. So I figure if I can do it, you know, if I can bless somebody with a meal or a smile or to help them from going in that direction. Just, hey, I'm Natasha Tovey. It's okay to be cool. Mm-hmm. It's okay. So, you know, at the end of the day, you know, it's just important to be able to humble myself. Mm-hmm. And say, this could be my dad, this could be my brother, this could be my son. So, you know, pretty much I just do it just for my heart.
Annually or monthly?
I do it every year.
Okay.
At Christmas time.
Right.
Around 2 weeks before Christmas, you know, get the date, save the date, get the good word.
Okay. Tell us a little bit about why you come here. You had a testimony to share with the gentleman.
Today, especially this season of my life, it's all about volunteering and giving back. I realize that through prayer and time with God, He keeps speaking to me that all the things that I'm asking for are already within me.
Yeah.
And so instead of just seeking more things and wanting more out of life, just stop trying to experience life and let life experience you. And that means share your gifts.
It's something that I learned a while ago. It's in the Bible, and I learned about a mantra, something that you repeat. Sometimes it's a sound. Sometimes it's a phrase you say over and over again to yourself, because it's almost like an internal pep rally to keep yourself going. Because a lot of times we accomplish things and we overcome things in life, but then I know, maybe some of you guys know, there's this relapse. And we're like, man, how did I get back to where I thought I was delivered from? I thought I had victory over it.
Mm-hmm. And that means at no cost.
Mm-hmm.
That means volunteer, give, and help people. Man, just really just see that God can do anything to those who believe in Him and that press through the difficult times. So I'm here really today just to inspire, hoping that my story and the words that God has given me give them some kind of hope and help them see who they really are beyond their flesh.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I'm here, just to really just to give so that they can go and give somebody else. And we can change the entire world to truly believe and know that God can do anything if they believe and have hope.
That nothing can shake you. It doesn't matter what the enemy says to you. It doesn't matter what your past. People who knew you from the past, they've seen you spread out.
So we're back. So we went there, and I just showed you a snippet of the video of what we did. But you know,
that was
the
awesome.
Whole, the full video will be up on the website. But I mean, I just didn't want to take
Thank
too
you,
much
sir.
Away
oh, no,
from
we
Robert
good.
Christopher Wiley.
Hey, here. Hey, you know.
Because I'm so interested. But I mean, I do feel compelled to let everyone know that, you know, everyone can have a need at different times in their life. Like,
yeah.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? And so I really felt good about it. I'm glad that TP, you introduced me to LaShawna. Was it LaShawna?
Yeah.
LaShawna from the Rescue Mission. That's
I
dope.
Just, I felt like that was a good thing that we were involved with. But back to Mr. Robert Christopher.
Hey, we back to me.
About,
not
yeah.
that I'm more important than the
talked
Rescue Mission, because I ain't.
Massive.
But, yes.
We talked about his background.
Oh, wait, hold on. Before we finish, let me just tell you two things about Hollywood Massive.
Please.
One, Hollywood Carnival is June 25th,
June
2016. That's when it all really
goes
down.
Oh, that's my son's birthday. My son's birthday. I got it. I'm a member that day.
Yeah. Okay. So, but the other thing is on January 18th. During the Kingdom Day Parade.
We're about to be.
Hollywood Massive.
Same day as the launch of the start of season 3.
Same day as the premiere of season 3 of Hit the Floor.
Oh my God.
At 9 a.m. in the morning, we are going to have a carnival truck on the road during the Kingdom Day Parade.
Wow.
So we're going to have some old costumes, we're going to have some newer costumes, and we're going to have some people, anybody out there who wants to enjoy the vibe. So you don't need to have a costume. It's completely free. If you want to see what Hollywood Massive is like, all you got to do is RSVP HollywoodMassive@gmail.com. We will send you a confirmation, send you the information. You meet us on the road, and it's going down. Carnival style.
Beauty and the Beat.
Hollywood.
I'm letting you know in advance. We're
Come on.
Be
hey,
on
watch
show.
It. Watch
Uh-oh.
It.
Uh-oh.
We causing a scene.
Right.
Oh, doors.
Do you have any musical talents? Because, I mean, you.
I do. I do have musical talents.
Sing.
Yeah. I can sing. I can sing. I can I can play the drums. I play the guitar. Yeah.
That's sexy.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Do music from women, like, you know, it's just like, I don't know.
Well, you know, the only thing I've done publicly for, you know, would be
James.
Play the drums and sing,
right?
But most of the time my guitar is reserved for my girlfriend.
50 Shades of
I mean,
Bay.
You know, it's like, if you know how
is
to
that,
play the strings on the guitar,
is that Claudia Jordan?
You know,
can we he said girlfriend, so I'm saying.
And Claudia, because she got to get her feet done. But anyway, hi Claudia, I love you though, baby.
When I have a girlfriend,
I
have a girlfriend. I play the guitar for that person.
You get your quint
from the best man. All
right, that's what we're saying there. Yeah.
You get your quint from like the best man.
Yeah.
So look, listen. We want to get into like listen. January 11th, they're gonna do a countdown on VH1 about all the best moments of Hit the Floor season 1.
Oh, are they? They're doing that.
Real talk.
January 11th.
Before I met Rob.
Yeah.
Hit the Flow was I remember seeing like the previews before the show came out, and I was like, this is kind of, you know, because you always hear about the basketball players,
right?
And granted, the show is, you know, it's about the girls, the devil girls, and everything else. Mm-hmm. It was kind of like, you know, I'm a diehard Laker fan, and the Laker girls was kind of the first of the dancers.
Yeah.
So I was like, this is interesting. That was smart.
It was.
To me, it was smart. And shout out to the writer
James LaRosa, the creator of Hit the Floor. Bless him.
James. I was like, that's smart. And when I saw the first show, I was hooked. So shout out to James.
You said it's your dynasty season.
The third season. Shout out, you know, it's not a small feat. We got to the third season, and usually, you know, it's been a little weird because it didn't come out on the same schedule that people are used to. So it's been a while. A lot of people are like, where's the show been? Blah blah blah. You know, obviously some people attributed our hiatus, an extended hiatus, to the tragedy that we had, involving Stephanie's passing.
Yes.
That is not why the show was delayed at all. None of the people that are on the show have any idea why the show was delayed. We don't know. We shot this all the way in May. Okay. The network does what they do when they do it. Shout out to VH1, because that has worked every other time that they put a Hit the Floor out, so it should work this time, right?
They
know their formula. Let me not get in the kitchen and mess up mama's soup.
Right.
Okay,
right.
I'm going to just go ahead and sit at the table and eat.
It looks like it's a lot going on.
Yo,
there is a lot going on.
Special delivery for you.
Hey, I don't even know what you're talking about.
I'm like, whoa.
Yo.
She said special delivery.
Where is Terrence?
Hey, message. I want to know how Terrence Wall knee is. Last season, I was like,
well, nah, look. Terrence. It was one of those like Kevin Ware fractures, right? So it wasn't his knee. It was like that you know, your tibia. Your tibia snaps in half, right? So it actually isn't anywhere near as bad as like if he had torn ACL or something like that. So it's not that hard to come back from. But Paul George had the same thing happen, and he's back better than ever. So, you know,
Kobe
if
Bryant
you...
Well,
it's because Kobe Bryant's like 73.
Hey, hold on, bro.
In NBA years.
Hold on, man. I got my Kobe
in NBA
zone.
Years. Congratulations. Those are nice shoes.
I'm a fan now.
Those are great shoes.
No.
I actually don't have a basketball allegiance, which is why I can be completely unbiased in this. Bryant is the man. One of the best basketball players ever in the history of basketball.
Counting up
period.
With Terrence Wall.
Yeah, exactly. Shout out to that guy. But Kobe is the man. But Kobe's 80 years old in terms of basketball years. Because he came out right after high school. He was one of the last people that they allowed to do that, right?
Years.
LeBron was last, and then that was the whole Jermaine O'Neal thing, right? Yeah. So Kobe's how old now? 30. How old is Kobe?
37.
So he's been in the league for 19 years then. 20 years. So it's 20 years. I mean, listen, 20 years of anything is a long, long time. And the man has been he's been the man for so long. It's okay for him to be old and his knees to not work.
So I do my research. And granted, you know, I've watched damn near every episode Hit the Floor.
Thank you,
sir. Like I said, I've known you for about good, almost 2 years.
Yeah.
And granted, when we met, we met somewhere out and about Hollywood, and my man was grooving with some of the cast members.
Yeah. It was during season 1.
That's right.
Right, it was at Couture.
That's right.
Right, where my man has a restaurant in the back of Couture right now, Taste of the Caribbean LA, which is, and I am part of the reason that story even exists, because that was where we had our we had our breakfast party.
And significant other in the show who was just...
Yelena, bless her heart. Logan Browning, she's a beautiful woman.
Lord knows if I ever see her out and about,
I'm gonna
just be like, "Hi, can I take you a coffee, drink, Kool-Aid, something?"
You go ahead and do that. That's what you say.
She can come on the show. That's all I care about.
She could come on the show.
Tell her I'd love to have her on the show.
I will be more than happy to relay that message. That is a message I will relay.
Cast member, well, I want to make.
I'm gonna see them all on Saturday. We getting together.
Please, we would love that. We would love it. But the point I'm trying to make is, After last season, I'm good friends with the murderer.
Oh, J-Mac.
Hey, that's my boy. I'm known him good for people. Years. South Libio. But,
He was just Jonathan just had surgery.
Just had surgery.
I hope you're fine.
Recovered.
I guess you're. I tried to text you. I think your number changed. Either that or you're ignoring me.
I hope you're feeling better, man. After last season and doing a little homework on this upcoming season, I think Terrence had a little affair or something.
Whoa, hey, I don't know. First of all, let's tune into season 3, which starts January 18th on VH1, 9 p.m. Hey. Okay, but shameless self-promotion. It's the storyline is definitely interesting. Somebody shows up and they say that the baby is Terrence's, and just like
I got a package for him.
And since he's an athlete and et cetera,
that part.
And that's not the woman that he's with. Of course, the questions are raised as to whether or not that's his child.
Right.
And we will see whether or not that's his trailer.
You know, we got a trailer.
Message
Monday. So January 18th, you're coming back.
Mm-hmm.
Uh huh. Mm-hmm. And that will be at on VH1.
That's right.
That's right.
And then the season
at one. Nine. It's gonna be at 9 o'clock
West Coast time.
9 p.m. West Coast, January 18th. But the show is on at 10 p.m.
We're gonna be on that Monday. We're gonna be on MLK.
Yes, MLK. That's right. So what we're gonna do is basically we're gonna have a party all day January 18th from 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm gonna hold your attention. It's gonna be nothing but music and drinks and vibes and a good time. And we're gonna take that all the way up to my premiere screening that I will personally have here in Los Angeles, which you are all invited to. And we're going to have a viewing party, and I'm going to have my DJs, DJ Spice, DJ Freeze International from New York City. I got all my people from right here, DJ Brandy Garcia, DJ Crazy Chris, the party minister, DJ Courtesy, DJ Cuddy. We in the building. DJ Willy Wonka from Elusive Radio. I'm telling you, we are. I'm going to show you all the culture that's in Los Angeles.
I can show you, baby.
Yeah, for real.
Willy Wonka mixtape out.
Yes, so DJ Willy Wonka has a mixtape release party that is tomorrow at Zanzibar. Reggae Thursdays in Santa Monica. So tomorrow night, come out, check out my man DJ Willy Wonka, Elusive Radio, Team Soca, Hollywood Massive Family. That's right.
So we're gonna watch. How is Rob Riley different from Terrence?
Well, you know what? We actually have a lot in common. We have a lot in common.
Y'all both swole.
We both eat weights for a living. We have a lot in common in that Terrence is obviously an educated dude. He's a respectful dude. He understands the platform that he has. He's a distinguished gentleman. He cares about his woman. He et cetera, et cetera. I embody all those things in Terrence. Because the show has such a diverse cast and such a thick plot.
Right.
There's so many storylines.
It's real thick this year.
It's extra thick.
Every time I'm like, oh my God.
All these storylines, you don't get to see all these different sides of Terrence. So I can't say that Terrence doesn't cut loose the way Rob does, but if anybody really knows me, they know when it's time to throw down, the cut loose is on another level. It's a different level. I'm the minister of vibes. Well, you're going to see that January 18th if you come on out to Martin Luther King Day, because we're going to be commandeering that truck something serious.
Okay, well, we got Hit the Floor for season 3 coming up, right. And we're going to show the trailer, but K-West.
Don't fake the funk and make sure you come.
I got to give shouts out to both of y'all being Libra.
Oh, Achievement, y'all.
Oh, my God.
When's your birthday? Yeah.
September 24th.
Nice. Yeah. Cusp. She's a cusp, baby.
I'm on the cusp. I kick it off.
What else are you on the cusp of?
What do you say?
Nothing. Go ahead.
Nah, let's go ahead and go to the trailer. Two cups on that one.
What do you say? Tomorrow.
I said, the mamba. I'm about to be up in there tomorrow.
On the cusp. You're a cusp, baby.
I said you're on the cusp.
You're on the cusp.
I said you are on the cusp. And then I said, what else are you on the cusp
tough,
of?
Man.
You still a Libra, but
Libra's cool, but it's all about the Leos.
Look at her face.
She's like, what?
Leos.
What?
Leos.
Get her.
Get her.
Play this thing, or the Taurus. Because I'm about to have an attack on camera.
Sorry, I can't chat. I'm so busy with auditions. Such a strong crop this year.
Hopefully no one too strong.
We're bad bitches!
On this court,
going for the win himself.
You can have it all.
Winning a spot on this floor is hard. Keeping it, well, that's a whole lot harder.
Oscar Kincaid, you're under arrest for the murder of Mia Sertner.
You have no idea what you've done.
I know my worth, and I want to be somewhere where the people around me know it too.
We could be killing it together. I know what you want.
Be gentle.
What's up, revenge sex?
I am Derek Roman. I need to choke on the dollar signs.
You like deals. I got one for you.
You don't want to make an enemy of me.
Sometimes people can drive you to do things. Things you never thought you could do in a million years.
Can you imagine getting away with murder?
I love you.
Love isn't enough.
I'm fighting for what I want.
I'm not gonna stay here just to watch you fall in love with him.
I'm coming for her.
German, no! I'm not afraid of Oscar. What makes you think I'm afraid of you?
I don't need you to be afraid. I need you to be smart.
You're a devil girl, whether you're dancing or not. Start acting like one.
I don't just want you. I need you.
Yelena Howard? I'm looking for Terrence.
I have something that belongs to him.
We stay on top. We stay on top.
Do I have your attention now?
Hey! Hey!
Yeah.
Damn, I damn near forgot how good my show is. Go ahead. Hit the flow. January 18th. Hit the flow. Hit the flow in the building.
I love that shit.
Hey, Terrence. I got a present for you.
Yeah.
What's up?
I got a present for you.
January 18th.
Special delivery.
Hey, Terrence, going down.
We got Martin Luther King Parade.
Oh, yeah.
We got the launch of the season 3 for BeautyandtheBeat.
Yeah, yeah.
Beauty and the Beat will be there January 11th. If you didn't catch season 1 and 2, they got a countdown
of
everything that you missed. So when you can get ready to get into the
come on now.
So get into it.
Do your research.
Do your research. Robert Christopher Wiley is in the building.
Don't they got the marathon coming up?
They do. Like January 11th.
January 11th, as we say, yeah.
Yeah, it's Monday. And then we got Robert Christopher, Hollywood Massive.
Hollywood Massive is in the building. Bop, bop, bop.
I'm getting my Chris Tucker.
Yeah. You know what's best about that? There's a whole new movement. Well, I mean, it's not that new, but there's it's picking up steam called Afro Soca, which is all bringing soca music, which is, you know, the music that predominates the Caribbean soca and calypso and reggae, of course. But it's bringing soca back to a lot of the African roots and the African rhythms. So you're getting a lot more of the Afro beat type music within the soca, so you get
that Afro music. He got that rhythm. He just got a rhythm to
it.
That's why he said, "Ladies, if you was with his woman, you could play his guitar string."
Sure, you could be mine and just see walk.
Hey, listen, that all comes from somewhere. I'm sure somewhere in Africa there's a guy creep walking. Like, I don't know what they are talking about. This is not creep walking. This is we have walked this way for years.
Rob, where can people find you?
Where can you find me?
I know
my address. No, it's at Rob Riley NYC, Instagram and Twitter, and of course Hollywood Massive is at Hollywood Massive on Instagram, at We Want Mass MAS on Twitter, RobRileyNYC.com. Holla at me, HollywoodMassive@gmail.com.
And
send us an email.
January 18th, VH1.
January 18th, 10 p.m. Actually, January 18th, 9 p.m., VH1, The Return of Hit the Floor. It's season 3. It's your boy, Terrence Wall. My name's Robert Christopher Riley.
But if you want to see...
But how does your body... Like, it's just a quick question.
Oh, no!
Just a quick question.
You know, have you been...
Oh, no!
Because, I mean, your body...
Oh, pineapples.
I was like, damn.
You know...
Those real abs, because, you know, they
they're real abs. No airbrush. They're real.
Oh, my God.
Make sure you get that.
She's touching me right now.
I got scared. Go ahead, Rob. You got to get the ladies with them. Blue, you're my boy.
No, it's
your boy.
The abs are real.
Something got moist.
I have been an athlete for a long time. I never really stopped. I played football for many years, and I haven't stopped lifting weights. I've got great people that I work out with. My big brother, Ronald Jean, over at Equinox in Beverly Hills. So, yeah.
I'm about to work out starting tomorrow.
Yeah. Lifting weights. Yeah. Right. I'm going to do my best.
And then, so you have like an athlete type regimen. Yeah. When you work out.
Exactly.
So, it's, you know, on screen or off screen, you got that stuff together.
You
got
to be ready.
Okay. So, Rob Riley. NYC.
That's right, Rob Riley, NYC.
January 18th,
VH1. January 18th, VH1.
You want to see him in person.
That's right.
Kingdom Day Parade.
That's right, Kingdom Day Parade, January 18th. If you want to see it in person, Hollywood right. Massive, Terrence Wall, Hit the Floor, we in the building. I'm going to have some special guests with me, too, because my Hit the Floor cast are here.
Hey, Cerise, I'm gonna take over for the next 5 minutes real
quick
for you.
Thank you, go ahead.
Because I want you to have fun with the abs. In fact, both of y'all can have fun with the abs.
Hey.
But before we wrap up.
I'm about to sit on his lap.
As you should. Go
what
ahead,
is happening
please.
Right now?
In fact,
what is happening? The engineer has quit.
Pissed off. Before we wrap up, I want to welcome everybody to a welcome 2016.
Yes, Happy New Year, people.
Happy New Year. And I have to say this real quick.
You didn't put no ginger ale in my drink.
I put some ginger ale in your drink.
You can't even some. Get straw.
Gotta use your tongue properly. But I have to say this. And my engineer's ready for this. Oh, I see. No. You can't talk about somebody real quick. Hold on, pineapples. Before we talk about Indians, before we wrap up, I have to say this because I saw some of your New Year's Eve pictures.
I was drunk.
Ooh.
Around, let's go ahead and show Sharice real
quick. I was drunk.
Oh, and then
I
was told she was ready.
That is sexy,
she was ready.
Look at them lips. Look at them flicking that lip.
That lip.
Hey, look at it. Hey, that's
that what lip.
In the New Year. But it gets even better. You know why? When you have Cerise Styles and TP at the same place, this is what you have, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, no.
Bring it in real quick.
Oh! Take it to the tape. Hey, look at the flick of that lip.
I love it. I love it, ladies and gentlemen.
That lip.
I have to applaud that.
And the drinks were on fire. She hates that post, though.
As you know, y'all was here on the East West Coast. Your man K West was out there in Atlanta doing what I do. People's looking at me like, you're not from here. I said, I know I'm not from here, baby. It was the most interesting man from LA. Uh-huh. Atlanta edition. Uh-huh. I had to bring in the new year properly. So I have to share this with everybody in
Happy
the world.
216.
No, 2016. Well, that's.
Shout out to GBM New Trail. I brought the music with me. I brought it with me.
Oh, yeah, baby.
No.
GBM Neutron, we causing a scene in here. It's Beauty and the Beat Radio.
Great show today. We out of here. Cerise Styles, my man Rob Riley.
Yeah.
Your man Wes.
Thank you.